Marcy over at Learning Curve Acres has tagged me in the 12 questions. It should be at the top of the page there, babe.
Well, I don't know what the questions are for. Little homestead by the beach?
What? She was tagged by Little Homestead by the beach. And I somehow managed to not print the name of the tag, but it will be in the name of the video, so you guys will know before I do. Good morning, YouTube, and happy St. Party's Day. When I sat down here, I noticed we have three of the Sugar Rush Peach have breached the soil surface. Maybe four. Maybe five. Awesome.
Awesome.
No movement yet on the leeks and onions or the chestnuts. Hopefully we'll get some more seeds planted this afternoon. I should have brought it downstairs. The cabbage has started putting out little cabbage heads at each of the leaf nodes. And the little white leaves up at the top that we left have started turning a medium green. So it's definitely going to do something. what's the other thing? The bunching onions are doing really well. We haven't started cutting them yet, but we haven't made anything that needed onion greens, so.
Marcy over at Learning Curve Acres has tagged me in the 12 questions, and I somehow managed to not print the name of the tag, but it will be in the name of the video, so you guys will know before I do.
She has 12 questions.
Okay. Number one. What are your top two favorite ice cream flavors?
Now, Marcy expressed that her favorite flavor is the Chapman's Dark Cherry. And we do buy that all the time, but it is a poor excuse, a poor replacement for what it replaced, which was the Dark Chocolate Black Cherry. That for some reason they stopped making. They also make a blackjack cherry, which is milk chocolate ice cream and regular cherries. But both of those, that and the dark cherry, are poor excuses for a replacement for the dark chocolate black cherry. And then my other favorite ice cream, I don't think is made anymore either. About a million years ago, there was an ice cream shop in the Rideau Center up at the top level, just where you came in from the Department of National Defense, the upper bus mall, and they used to sell chocolate cheesecake ice cream that was to die for. But, you know, 40 years later, that ice cream parlor does not exist anymore. What are you doing, Mr. Bear?
Daddy's talking. Daddy's talking.
So, both of my favorite flavors of ice cream aren't made anymore. But those are them.
Number two, what is your favorite flower?
I don't really have a favorite flower. I have favorites in different categories. All of my favorite flowers are perennials. The columbine has been one of my favorites since before my daughter was born. Since moving here, one of my favorites has been the hardy hibiscus, and it has flowers about that big around. And ours is a dark, dark burgundy, or maroon, or burgundy. I had to Google it, but I finally figured out the difference between maroon and burgundy. Burgundy is red with purple added, and maroon is red with brown added.
Interesting.
So, and then my oldest favorite is dahlias. And, well, they're not, in this climate, they're not a hardy perennial. They're a bulb plant that you have to bring the bulbs in every year. But my dad used to grow dahlias, and they make me think of him.
Number three, if you could have any animal as a pet and cost was not a factor, what would it be? And don't say llama.
No, only if it comes from the dollar store. So it's a Dollarama llama. I have always had a thing with birds. Not so much a love of them, but they seem to love me. I remember back in high school, my buddies and I were in the basement playing Dungeons and Dragons, and the neighbor kid came over in a panic because she was trying to feed her mother's budgie, and it had an escape. And, God, Colleen was 8 or 12, something in that area at the time. So I went over, Sean and Rob came over with me to catch this bird and get it back in the cage before her mom got home from work. I walk in the door and the bird flies from the top of the light fixture in the corner and lands on my arm. Not 2 feet in the door. A buddy of mine rescued a pigeon and rehabilitated it so that it could fly away and do pigeon things. And it was forever flying off of his shoulder and landing on mine. And another buddy of mine, much later, had a Swainson's hawk. And I went over one day, and he was actually working with it at the time. You know, so he had the big welder's glove, hawk glove on, and it was on its perch without the leg tie fastened and without the mask on. I walked in the door and it flew over and landed on my arm. Gently. Everybody says, oh, you have to wear that big leather gauntlet when you're working with hawks because their claws will rip your arm apart when they land. And it landed on, it was summertime, I was in short sleeves, it landed on my arm. Did not draw a drop of blood, did not form a scratch. And I watched a video recently about taming crows and making crows your friend. And back when I worked at the truck repair center, the big truck repair center here in Ottawa, in the fall, it's not really a field because there's a lot of scrub trees. It was a field when I was a kid. There were trees that were more than 20 years old all scattered through it. None of them had been planted. They were all just windfalls. And there would be so many crows that you could not see the trees. Probably 10,000 crows, and I'm not trying to exaggerate. And I would walk through, and they would caw and cackle at me as I walked past the tree they were at, but they weren't panicked by me, or... And then... There was a little girl, and her mother followed me about 30 yards behind me to come through, and the little girl was commenting about how neat it was with all the crows, and as they entered the area where the crows were, the crows just freaked out. So, actually at one point going through there, I had a crow come down and perch on my shoulder. So, the one pet would be either a hawk or an owl hunting raptor type, or a crow or a raven.
Raven.
Nevermore.
Okay, number four. What is your favorite dish to make when you have company?
Back before the plague, Grumpy Old Man used to come for a visit basically the first week of every month for 2, 3, 4 days. And he would bring with him either a leg of lamb or a salmon. Those are both my favorites to cook when we have guests, especially when the guest supplies them. Actually, I think Tora's favorite to cook for guests is turkey. You look for reasons to have guests to cook turkey.
So I can make leftovers. Number five. Sorry. What is your all-time favorite movie and why?
Oh, that's easy. My all-time favorite movie is The Razor's Edge, which is based on a book by Somerset Maugham. It actually starred Bill Murray, and it was a serious dramatic role for him. It was about a up-and-coming business tycoon who was supposed to marry into one of the richest families in the United States, and he got called up to go to Europe for excuse me, for the First World War, and he was in an ambulance brigade during the First World War, and he came back from the First World War, what they used to call back then, shell-shocked. And the movie is all about his search for inner peace and tranquility. He went and studied in Tibet, and he went and studied in India, and he went and worked in the coal mines in Wales, and studied with a coal miner, but who was into all the esoteric teachings, who was from Scotland, and then he went to live in Paris, France, and his ex-fiancée and her husband came and tracked him down because of the Great Depression, and they lost everything, and it's absolutely my favorite movie. Hmm. That did cover why, didn't it?
Yep. What is your favorite book or book series? Narrow it down, babe.
I can narrow it down to two. It would have to be either Piers Anthony's Xanth series or Terry Pratchett's Discworld trilogy, for which there are 14, 15 novels. But it started out being touted as a trilogy, I think till after the sixth novel came out.
Okay. Number 7. What is your favorite fictional character and why?
Does character have to be hominid?
I don't think so. It's fictional.
From it was a tie. Both are from Terry Pratchett's Discworld series. First one would be The Luggage. It's a steamer trunk with 100 feet, and it follows Rincewind around, and at points had rescued him by charging things that were being aggressive towards the wizard Rincewind. The other one, again from Terry Pratchett series is death.
We are on number 8. What is your favorite thing to grow in your garden? Something for the shade garden?
Yes. I went through a list of seeds that we wanted to procure for our shade garden last fall when I put the shade garden in. And I haven't bought a single one of those yet, so that was 4 or 5 different
seeds. More like 10.
No, because some of them are perennial plants that can only be gut through division, so.
Oh, okay. Number 10, what are your top 3 activities you look forward to every year?
Seed sowing.
Organizing is not part of that one.
I don't know. Seed sowing and canning are my 2 definite favorites. Planting and harvesting are sort of tied for the other one.
We so differ. I so hate bending over to plant.
Well, yeah, that's why I keep inventing tools to make the planting less bendy overy.
Okay, number 11. What is your favorite hot beverage in the winter?
Well, that's easy. Coffee.
always black coffee.
Black coffee, no sugar. I'm already sweet enough.
Ah, sorry. Number 12. If you woke up and there was snow on the ground, you'd be living in Ottawa, what would your preferred activity to do?
If there was snow on the ground, well, that's like October to April.
And you'd still be walking out with nothing on your feet.
My favorite activity would be clearing the door to the shop to see if it's warm. I can get it warm enough in there to do some work.
Okay, and number 13 is tag 3 channels to do the same 12 questions.
Okay, they're written on the bottom of the back of that, and you put the thing down so I can't see it. Okay, so first, ecocentric homestead. He is out in Newfoundland. He's definitely worth checking out. He has a bachelor's, I forget, Bachelor of forget what he said, Bachelor of Arts or a Bachelor of Science. But everything he does is well researched. Chris at Exploring Nature Together, she's down in Southern Ontario. The name of the city slips my mind, but she is an allotment gardener, and the dog is going bananas upstairs. And she's a wonderful photographer, and she does lots of nature photography, and so everybody go check out her channel as well. And third, well, that would be Dave and Amanda at the Wilderstead. They are probably the best Canadian homesteading channel, in my opinion. So everybody go over and check out their channel as well. They have some of the best content ranging from cooking, gardening, animals, off-grid, just about everything. So there's my three picks to tag in this. Why are you looking so guilty, Bear?
Tell him who you saw. Go.
Come here. What are you, a snake? You can't go in a straight line through? Come on, up. Up.
Yeah.
Look at Mummy.
He was barking at Goosey. Because the geese keep getting out of the goose yard.
Yeah, the snow's up high enough that the geese have no problem to get over the 4-foot-tall fence. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. With my love and leave this life behind.